a galvanic cell. Clean the metal strips with sandpaper. You know it's clean when it is shiny like this. Fill a 50 ml beaker with approximately 35 ml of 0.1 molar copper sulfate and fill another 50 ml beaker with approximately 35 ml of 0.1 molar zinc sulfate. Set up the apparatus as shown. Rinse the salt bridge with distilled water before placing it into the two half cells. You can now record the value of the cell potential. And repeat the steps by replacing the zinc half cell with the other half cell given or listed in the lab manual. Now you can calculate the standard reduction potential of each electrode. And finally, you can also arrange the metals in ascending order of strength as reducing agents. And now part B, determination of Faraday's constant. Clean a copper electrode with a piece of sandpaper. Weigh the copper electrode accurately. Fill a 50 ml beaker with approximately 35 ml of 1 molar copper sulfate. Set up your apparatus as shown. Set the transformer to a voltage of 4 volts. Run the electrolysis for 15 minutes. Record the observations and the emitter reading. Dry the copper strip using hairdryer. Weigh the copper strip. And calculate the mass of copper deposited. Finally, you can now determine the Faraday's constant.